India is passing through a phase where fingers are being pointed at institutions which are supposed to function independently. Never before has the judiciary and media, which have always carried the impression of being spotlessly independent, been questioned and doubted as they have been in contemporary India. This is in that regard. We have such a beautiful constitutional setup in our country. No other country can boast of such a constitutional scheme where various organs of the state can function seamlessly together and, if need be, exert checks and balances to course correct the other organ as and when it commits an error in its functioning. But sadly, we Indians have not been able to take the full benefit of this beautiful constitutional setup. The constitution makers envisioned an India where all the diverse people from various backgrounds would pool in their collective talents and make good use of it. Where people could come together irrespective of their caste or creed and work together for their common betterment. Diversity has been the biggest strength of our country, but the ruling class from ages in India has misused and abused this diversity for their own selfish and narrow ends. It will be even in the interest of ruling class in the long run to use the diversity of our country for the betterment of its people, for the people of India never forget anyone who does the slightest good for them. We the common men, the people of India, need to look through the selfish and self-centered interest of the politicians as and when they instigate us. The word secular has been given a wrong definition by the current rulers. They have bastardized this word to mean favoring Muslims, when the original meaning of this word is giving favor to no religion or without religion. And the unsophisticated, innocent, simple people who are not very educated have been handed down the wrong definition made permanent in their minds through the heavy propaganda machines run by the government. Under these situations, it is imperative for the institutions to buckle up and start functioning properly. Institutions function as trustees of the power vested in every person. The soul of India resides in every individual. They may be rich or poor, educated or uneducated, sophisticated or unsophisticated, but one thing is certain. There is a deep sense of right or wrong in everyone. Even when the one they support is winning, they know whether he is right or wrong. And this blind or motivated support may help the leader on one or more instance, but in the long run, it's the desire to stand up for what right that trumps in India. That is why, despite various attempts that have been made in the past, authoritarian regimes have not succeeded. It just gave them a bad name in history books. India truly needs a leader who can unite them, and the country will lovingly welcome such a leader. Indians are by nature open to changes and give an opportunity to anyone who is willing to work for them. Therefore, the institutions, if they think that they can play to the Pied Piper, it will be futile in the long run, because conditions will change and rectitude will be established. The ones in institutions who do their work right will remain etched in the minds of people forever, even after they are gone, and the ones who don't will rot in the pages of history books as crooks and stooges of the ones in power. Therefore, a piece of advice to the ones holding positions of power in various institutions. Buckle up.